Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this collective concert between the Manitoba Trombone Collective and the Chamber Flute Orchestra. I'd like to thank you for joining us today, and please join me in welcoming the Manitoba Trombone Collective under the direction of Joel Green. As you are able, please rise for the playing of the National Anthem. So thank you very much, and thank you, Jets fans, for resisting the temptation to yell out True North. That was an arrangement by our very own Stuart Smith, who is a member of the Manitoba Trombone Collective. So thank you, Stuart. We'll be continuing with an original arrangement by our director, Mr. Joel Green. This is Fanfare for a New Trombone. And it's based loosely on the march past of the Royal Canadian Air Force. And Joel also adds, or it might be about ponies. So enjoy Fanfare before a common trombone.
Thank you.
thanks for your patience through the transitions. We're moving around and moving around and moving around to keep parts organized. I'm Art Zook, and I'm your MC for this evening. I should have introduced myself from the beginning. I'd like to take a moment to thank Chris Wolf for being here this evening from Classic 107, who's been promoting this concert. Thank you very much, Chris. Longer. It is the overture from The Magic Flute by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. And this work was composed in 1791 and performed shortly before Mozart's untimely death in 1791. It was originally scored for two flutes, two oboes, two clarinets, two bassoons, two horns, two trumpets, three trombones, timpani, and strings. Rembrandt Malmström has vastly improved the instrumentation with what you're going to hear. This is The Magic Flute, and as a side note, although the trombone ensemble is playing The Magic Flute, unfortunately, the flute ensemble will not be playing the magic trombone this evening.
Come on.
This next piece is a bit of an inside joke that I think you need a little bit of context for. If you don't know what an internet meme is, this is based on a meme, this is based on a meme that was going around the internet a little bit ago. It's an arrangement called Trollololo. And what the when Chris handed this out in rehearsal a few weeks ago, or a couple of months ago, and we first started playing it, people were kind of snickering as it went along and laughing. It's like, oh yeah, I know that. And I had no idea what it was. And I live on the internet, just ask my wife. And I just can't, I had never heard it before. And so what this is, it's based on an internet meme, and it goes back to 1976. And the person who sang this is a Soviet singer. He's this big star, he was like the American Idol of the 70s in Russia. and he sang this on an American, not American, but on a Russian TV show. And he got uploaded to YouTube in 2010. Somebody found old footage of this, and it went all over the internet. So if you type in Trollolol on YouTube, not right now with your phones, but later, you'll get on the inside of this joke. So this guy is strutting around stage doing this kind of pseudo-scat thing on a Russian folk song. So our Russian star today is Mick, and he will be our Trollolol soloist. And it's a bizarre little bizarre little Latin tune. I think you'll really enjoy it. I'll look it up afterwards if you're not familiar with it. It's a lot of fun. Trollolol.
Just to give a little bit more context to this tune, so it actually originated because a songwriter and a lyricist got into an argument, and the songwriter the writer of the tune did not like the lyrics to the song, and the lyricist said, well, you have to use my lyrics. And the songwriter said, absolutely not. I'm going to write a hit without your lyrics. So, here you go.
This is an arrangement of Lush Life by T.S. Galloway. And this is a world premiere, as far as we know. It is a world premiere of this particular arrangement of Lush Life, this jazz standard. Stuart Smith has been in contact with T.S. Galloway and emailing him. He summarized some thoughts for us from T.S. Galloway as we premiere his work. He says, I'm a Chicago native living in Amsterdam. My professional career spans 50 years, beginning at age 21 and subbing for Buster Cooper and Duke Ellington's trombone section, then as a sideman for the Count Basie Orchestra, and later as a composer and arranger. In addition to performing and writing, I've taught in Chicago's Columbia College, North Central College, Naperville, Illinois, and for 10 years at the Amsterdam Conservatory. This arrangement was done a few years back, but rehearsed, but never performed. I was inspired to write it after having heard the trombone choir at the Tennessee State University in Knoxville when I was living there. And he adds, I met Stuart through a mutual friend in Chicago and gave him the score and parts about 10 years ago with a promise he would do his best to have it performed. So 10 years later, here we are with Lush Life. Featured on solo trombone, the Joel Green.
Been conducting for 3 years. They said, unless you play something, you're out.
Thank you.
So this is a charity concert that is supporting the Hands of Hope. And so we have a representative here from the Hands of Hope who going to be saying a few words about the charity and about what you're supporting tonight. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Switching gears here briefly between the trombones and to a slightly less dangerous instrument, I'm thinking. No, Charmaine says no. Especially the one you'll see, the one that's standing over there. It's a little, looks dangerous. I want to just introduce a little bit for those of you who don't know what Hands of Hope is. Hands of Hope is an organization right here in Winnipeg that's providing furniture and household items to people who desperately need it. So basically what we do is we bridge the gap between people who have stuff they don't need anymore and people who really need it. So if you have furniture and you're not sure what to do with it, you give us a call because we have a waiting list of people who really very much need it. So when I talk about need, we're talking about people who are sleeping on the floor, who are need to be released from the hospital, and they don't have beds, or they don't have, if you talk refugees coming into Canada, they don't have anything. So we can furnish a whole home for about $250, and that'll service the entire home from furniture, household items, dishes, and everything. But we rely on the generosity of people in the neighborhood like you, and the generosity of groups like that are performing tonight to help us work. So I want to thank you all for coming here tonight. I thoroughly enjoyed seeing that many trombones together. I've never seen that before. This is fantastic. And I just can't wait to hear what the flutes are going to do next. And if I'm right, the trombones are coming back shortly to join the flutes, right?
Yes.
Excellent. All right, enjoy the rest of the evening. And if you want to talk more about Hands of Hope, I'll be in the back after the performance. Thank you.
So thank you very much. We'll be moving on now to our next section of the concert, which features the Chamber Flute Orchestra out of Winnipeg. And you'll see a number of different flutes here. If you're used to seeing just the one type of flute and a piccolo, there we go, here's the start of the show. The contrabass flute. It's Carl.
His name is Carl.
His name is Carl. It is a male flute. We're not sure how that was determined exactly, but it is a contrabass flute, and it's my understanding it's one of four in the country.
Three.
One of three in the country. So Carl doesn't come on too often, but when he does, he means business. So not only the contrabass flute, but we also have the bass flute and very many different sizes of flutes, depending on how long we left them in the dryer. So they're going to be starting off with a Susato dance suite, and this is 1591 Renaissance music, originally written for four recorders, is my understanding, at least that's what I found on the internet. And it's transcribed for many, many instruments, and it's beautifully done for flute choir. Please join me in welcoming Charmaine Bacon and the Chamber Flute Orchestra.
Thank you.
Songs of the Ocean was first premiered in 1994 by Jim Marshall and Master Chorale, composer Rio Hiroshi. Perhaps best known for his flute ensemble Blue Train, was a respected professor and administrator at Kyoto City in the University of Arts Music Department for more than 20 years, and originally wrote music for traditional Japanese instruments. The three pieces included here are There Was No Ocean, The Tufted Puffin, and the Lullaby for the Ocean represents some of his later work for traditional Western instruments and voices, and translate beautifully to flute part. Songs of the Ocean.
Thank you.
bossa nova jazz song. Even if you're not familiar with the title, I think that once they start playing, you'll find that you're familiar with the melody. It was originally written in 1962. It was a huge hit in the 60s, winning a Grammy for Record of the Year in 1965. Enjoy this arrangement by Ed Macta, flautist and arranger Kelly Villa, the girl from Ipanema. Following the performance of this final tune by the Windchamber Flute Orchestra, there'll be a little bit of a transition while we bring together all of the trombones and all of the flutes for a finale. So thank you very much, the Windchamber Flute Orchestra and the girl from Ipanema.
There's so many flute players on YouTube. There are a couple.
First Unity Plaque by Elizabeth Holes. This is one of the cornerstone works for a concert band that has. It's just one of these things that everyone has played if you're in band. And this is it was originally written in 1920, and this particular arrangement was done by Winnipeg's own Michael Cutler, and he's arranged the second movement. Intermezzo from the First Suite in E flat by Gustav Holst for this group in particular. So we thank you very much for your attendance this evening, and we have two numbers to play, with the first being this intermezzo for the First Suite.
Thank you.
supposed to get set up for our fine lumber. Just wanted to ask performers who are on stage, or the performers who may not be on stage right now, if you can hang around for just a moment so we can have a group picture of this momentous occasion with all these flutes and trombones in one place at the same time, making music together. It's a very unique experience. So thank you to all musicians involved, and thank you for being such a great audience for us tonight. We're going to end things off with a bit of a party. It's Trombone Country, and don't think I'm going to say anything more about it than that, but it is a grand old party, and thank you so much for coming. Enjoy. Thank you.